Hey everybody, it is Brooke with Re-Fabbed.
If you don't follow me, be sure you do, because you're probably not going to want to miss out on all the fun we have over there. It's quite a bit of fun, and you never know what you're going to get. So be sure to tell me hi. I don't see any comments coming through. And anyway, we're making a St. Patrick's Day gnome today. Now, you may have seen traditional type gnomes that it might all be done kind of the same way, but when I do something, hey there, Mandy, somebody finally said hi. Hey, Angel, I'm assuming this is Angel and not Chad, and hey, Martha. Okay, and hey, Sandra. Okay, everybody saying hi now. Good, okay. So, when I make gnomes, what I do is I just simply figure out what I've got around the house that we can use and what can make the right shapes and what can make the right look of my gnome, okay? So I don't follow all the traditional guidelines, which let me tell you this right now. I don't follow traditional guidelines in anything that I do. Look at my nails. I ran out of this color, so I just put this color on. Like, see, I mean, that's just how I am. So I found stuff I had on hand. This is a, what is this? Tin can. It's been spray painted black. We did these for our live event like a year and a half ago. We made snowman hats, and this was the top part of the hat. So I've got some of these left over. So it was in my craft stash. I'm like, perfect for a gnome. So we're starting with this. So you can take what I'm doing here and change it up any way you want to for your own project. I'm just kind of showing you what I do, and this is just inspire you to make your own. So we're using this, and then we have this really cool, it's too long, we're gonna cut it, St. Patrick's Day sock, okay? So we got this at Hobby Lobby, and look what we've got here. We've got this really cool yarn that's like, I don't know what you would call it. It's just really cool. We immediately thought that it looked like beard. So we got this big thing of yarn at Hobby Lobby. It's gonna be the beard for our gnome. Now we're gonna fill the sock with old socks that we can't find the match to, or that got turned pink in the washer, because you know, it happens. And we're gonna fill it with other random stuff that I have around the house, okay? We're gonna use paper shred, we're gonna use Valentine's tissue paper that was on clearance, all that, okay? Eyelash yarn, thank you, Angel. So we're just gonna use all this, we're gonna pull it together. We got a little wooden gnome nose, and we're just gonna see what happens. So I'm kinda excited to try it, and I hope you are too. I wanna tell you that before I get started, I went ahead and did this ahead of time because I knew it was gonna take too long to do on here, but I took a piece of ribbon, just like this. I took this piece of ribbon, and I went ahead and glued, and see, we gotta cut it. I didn't cut it ahead of time, but I went ahead and glued all this on so that we can wrap it around, because it took me a little bit of time to try to do this. I mean, it wasn't crazy, but I didn't want to take away from the live here. So when it comes time, we're going to wrap it around to make our beard, and then we'll trim it up and we'll add more so that you can't see. But I wanted to tell you, I already did this ahead of time, okay? So to get started, we are going to take, and I'm flying by the seat of my pants. I've not done this. This is just all in my head, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and take my sock and we're gonna cut it at the bottom because we don't need this part. I guess you could use it as a little, you know, no-show sock if you wanted to. Okay, so this part up here, we're gonna end up tying with some twine. We're gonna fill this up. We're gonna do something cute at the top, all that. So we don't have to worry about that. But we're gonna go ahead and put it, I'm just praying this works out. So we're gonna do this, because this is gonna be his hat. And then we're gonna fill it up with all of our fun stuff, and we're gonna hope that it looks good. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the socks in first, because y'all know, I hope I'm not the only one, surely I'm not. But how many of y'all literally have a thing full of socks with no matches? What happens to the socks? I really don't understand. I don't. I say it every day, where are all my socks? Why do we have 100 socks in the dryer and none of them have a match? Like, I do not understand what in the world happens. So I'm like, I'm going to use some of them for this. I don't know. It may look lumpy. It may not be a good idea, but I'm going with it anyway. So let's see. I don't have enough to fill the whole thing, which I knew I didn't. Well, you know, we can use the rest of this one. We're not going to use that. The main part of this is simply using what you've got on hand, not going and buying a bunch of stuff for your projects. Because if you look around your house, there are tons of things. I'm going to put it in my lap so I got a better handle on it. There's tons of stuff around your house you can do. So just be creative. I know y'all are creative if y'all are in this group. So I've got all, so it's looking up, it's coming along. It's a little lumpy, but that don't matter. So that's all the socks I have. So what we're gonna do now is start using the other stuff that I showed y'all I had on hand. This stuff is so messy, but I still love it. So it's a decorative shred. I have it left over from a project I did. So we're just gonna stuff it down in there. And then I'm gonna have to vacuum because it's gonna get everywhere. I can't play with this stuff without making a terrible mess. I know it's kind of boring right now, but it's gonna be cute in the end, I promise. I'm just not used to quietness. This decorative shred is working pretty good and it's filling in the gaps where the, I know y'all can't see it, I'm gonna show you, but I have to keep it in my lap so I can actually reach it better. Here's what it's looking like so far. See, it's coming up, standing on its own. It's really, really looking cute. In fact, I'll probably be done with this part and go ahead and just tie it. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go ahead and tie it up at the top. I got a piece of twine to use to tie it on. Hey there, Christy. I don't know if it's Christy. I think she's maybe somewhere else, but so we're just gonna tie it just like this. Okay, so it's looking super cute. And we can pull it down some more if we want to, but you can't forget that we're gonna have his beard along here too. So we don't need it too far down. And then of course his nose, we're gonna stick up under here in a little bit. So let's just keep going with it and see what happens. Like I said, this was all in my head, which is a scary place to be sometimes, but I had never done it live. I'd never done it at all. I need a drink of my coffee. So we're just doing it together. Okay, so I told y'all earlier that I went ahead and took a piece of ribbon, it was just like this, and went ahead and put all of my yarn, whatever she called it. What did she call it? I don't know. Whatever kind of yarn this was. And now I'm gonna go ahead, put it here, and hot glue it around this, okay? Now, it's wild right now. It's wild, we need to fill it in, we need to cut it up a little bit and all that kind of stuff, but we're gonna go ahead and hot glue it so that we can eyelash. I can't remember anything. So let's go ahead and get that done. Go ahead and put some hot glue. A little bit and then I'll put some more in a minute because I don't want it to dry on me. I'm sure y'all know this, but hot glue dries. Love that I'm just flying off the whim. Thank you, Amy. I'm gonna be straight up with you. That is the only way I even know to do it. I mean, I hardly ever plan a project. Anytime I go live on my page, and like I said, make sure you're following along there because we have a lot of fun at Re-Fabbed. Make sure you're following along. Half the time when I go live, I've never done it before. I'm just going with it. So it's kind of just how I am. Totally just a fly by the seat of my pants kind of gal. And I just realized something that I may have done wrong, but I'm gonna keep going and we'll see. And I didn't even measure this ribbon, and it was perfect. See? Okay. So we got it like this right now. Now he's got a super long beard, okay? Like this, I don't even know. So we're gonna cut it up in just a minute. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and cut these two pieces that I've got like super long. I'm gonna move that eyelash yarn to the side. I learned something new today, eyelash yarn. Didn't know, had no clue. So we got him like this. What I realized that I did was my nose. I wanted it to kind of be hidden up under the sock, but I have glued this to the sock. So I'm like, crap. So it's okay. I'm just gonna hot glue it right here on the outside. It's no big deal. It's not that big of a deal. But that wasn't my original plan. I did want it kind of hidden under the sock, but that's the least of my worries. So we're just gonna hot glue it to the outside. Let's see. I don't even know. Okay, so we're just gonna glue it like this. I want the little holes to go on the outside so that it so that you can't see them from the front. So I'm just gonna hold it here and make sure it sticks for a minute. Thank you, Sandra. She said that's perfect. And Pat says that she's following my page. Thank you, Pat. Super glad to have you. Okay, so this is still super cute. That wasn't my original plan, but look how cute, seriously. And you can always go in and add some of this if you don't want to see this, or add an embellishment here. We'll just keep messing with it until we can figure out. So now what I need to do is trim his beard up, okay? So I'm just gonna sit him right here. And then we need to add some more because we don't want to see the black through it. We want him to have a good fluffy beard. So I'm just gonna go on the bottom. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be even. It's supposed to hang kind of crazy. These scissors are not wanting to work hardly at all, and I don't know why. They're fairly new, but whatever. So I'm going to hold this to the side because we can use this same yarn to fill in the spots. So it kind of depends how long you want his beard to be, if he's gonna sit on a shelf or what he's gonna do. You don't want him to have a short beard, but you don't want it to be so long that it's too long. So let's see. Okay, so we don't have it even. We definitely need to cut this. It's kind of hard to tell when it's just laying here on the table. Couple more and then we'll start filling it in. Okay, so now this is what it looks like. Now you can see some of the black, so we want to go ahead and be filling some of this in, and we can always go cut it a little more later. I mean, you can cut it whenever. We're not going to spend too much time going back and cutting, but I'm just going to take little pieces of this, put a little hot glue on the top, and just start filling it in where I see it needs to be. That's all I'm gonna do. There's several spots right here in this one little area that I guess I kind of missed earlier. You probably can't even tell. It's gonna be hard for y'all to see on here, but we're just gonna kind of fill in some spots. And it all blends, woo, kind of hot. It all blends together, so it's really, so we need some right here. Under his nose. So it all blends together, so you don't have to get it perfect or in a certain spot. You just kind of stick it on there and it'll work. Try not to burn yourself like I just did. I have been crafting and doing stuff like this for years, and I cannot even tell y'all the amount of hot glue burns that I've had. You would think I'd learn. Gonna fill in a few more spots. Okay, let me see from back here. Okay, I need some right here. This is a little bit messy. I'm not even gonna lie to you, okay? It is a little bit messy. This eyelash yarn, as they say, is not, it is messy. But it's perfect for his beard. But I'm not gonna try to tell y'all it's not gonna make a mess all over the place. Cause it is. I'm gonna add just a couple more and then we're gonna embellish a little bit. I've got those finger covers, Linda. That's the thing. But I don't ever remember to use them when it's time for me to go live or whenever I feel like crafting or just whatever. I never think about getting them. So I burn my fingers. It's dumb. It's dumb, dumb, dumb. I need to add more, but I'm not gonna do that right now because it just takes too much time and that's really boring to watch. So I don't want to spend my time doing that. But here, I actually forgot a couple things. Imagine that. I've got some fun embellishments. I'm gonna ask my son to go get them. Hey, Blaze. Blaze. Is it ignoring me? Will you get off the island right in there? Will you get my St. Patrick's Day bag that has all my fun stuff in it? Thank you. Okay, so I have some fun embellishments. We'll just see if we want to use any of them. But here he is. He's got his little nose. He's got his sock filled with all that stuff. We just kind of did this at the top, kind of just took some twine and tied it in a knot, which I think this looks actually pretty cute, but you could do some kind of fun embellishment up here or a bow or whatever you want to do. It could be a girl gnome. And then we took the eyelash yarn and put it all around, and he is so adorable. But I'm going to show y'all some of the embellishments I have, and y'all can see if you think he needs any extra, okay? So, we have this little bit of like feather, let me move him to the side, like feather, whatever this even is. It says it's a clip, so we could kind of use this. It's like a boa, like a little bit of a boa. We have these fun little St. Patrick's Day stickers. Those are cute. And we have, I don't have a ton of extra stuff, but then we have these little gold coins, these little glitter coins. So what do y'all think? Do you think he needs any of this, or do you think he's good as he is? Or just kind of tell me what y'all think. I might kind of sit here. Let's see. I've got a couple other things in here, but they're kind of for another craft. So I'm going to kind of put those to the side because I'm not going to use those today for sure. But I need to hear. Okay, feather clip on the top of his hat. Yeah, we can try that. Let me take this off. I think he needs a little something. I just don't know. Well, I don't have any sunglasses, Vanessa. This is all I've got right here. So, I can't do that. But let me see if I can get this clip on. I don't have to use it as a clip. Oh, yeah. I'm not going to use it as a clip. I'm actually just going to hot glue the clip to the top of his hat. And that's a really good idea. How cute is that? Oh my gosh, the top of his hat, y'all. Oh, that is so cute. I love that. Okay, so I don't really know how we can use the gold coins for this project. They're super cute, but I'm gonna put those to the side. But let's get out one of the clovers. So that added everything. Good call on that.
Can we use the gold coins for?
Yeah, I don't think we're going to on this though. Okay, so let's take one of these clovers and maybe embellish a couple places on his hat. I think that would be really cute. Trying to get them because it's got all these little rhinestones and stuff. Okay, so it's a sticker, obviously. How cute is that sticker? So we could put it right here. Oh yes, I don't even have to hot glue it on. I really only think it needs one because you don't want to overdo it, but one little clover and then this, and how stinking cute is our gnome, y'all? OMG, I think he turned out super cute. And that was easy. This was so easy. That's the thing I like about gnomes. They're so popular right now. I know some people get, trust me, I get emails about how wrong it is for me to make gnomes. I get emails about everything, I can promise you. But I like them. I think they're super cute. They're fun to make. You could do it for every single holiday and kind of change it up. This turned out adorable. And you can always add more to the hat if you want to. And you could do whatever you want to make it your own. But this was cheap, easy, fast, fun, and absolutely adorable. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. I will show y'all a staged picture. I always do that after every live. I stage a picture so you can see it like in my house in a setting and get a better look at it. And I will post it in the comments. And that way you can get a better look at it. But I hope y'all enjoyed this. It's something kind of different than I think what y'all normally do in here. But I'm so happy that she asked me to come in here. It was super fun. Be sure to follow me on Re-Fabbed and become part of the Re-Fabbed family. Become part of my community over there. It's super fun. So y'all have an awesome day and happy St. Patrick's Day next Tuesday. Bye, guys.